Namaste everyone, I'm Kartini from Cooking with Kartini Kannan. Today we are going to look at one of the famous dishes in the land of the hornbills. Yes, Sarawak is famous for its midin, which is a fern dish. So here, let us look at the ingredients to do midin salad. This is actually paku. Midin is a little bit hard to find here, so I'm replacing it with paku, which is also a type of fern. I have here lemon, lime, shallots, and for some heat, I have here bird's eye chili, as well as torch ginger flower, which is also known as bunga kantan. For the flavorings, I have here a little bit of gula melaka syrup, and for a crunch, I have roasted peanuts. So let's look at how we are going to do our midin salad today. So in this bowl here, I have blanched the shoots, which is just the tip of the paku. So what you are left with is only the curled bits on top. So here I blanched it and then chilled it in the fridge. Along with that, I'll be adding in the finely chopped shallots, bird's eye chili, as well as torch ginger flower. For the flavoring ingredients, I'll be using a little bit of gula melaka syrup for the sweetness. For the tang, to balance it out, is a mixture of the lemon juice as well as the small limes that we saw just now. Along with that, I'll be adding in some salt. Sugar is not necessary at this stage because we have already added in the gula melaka syrup. Once I've added in the ingredients, I'll give it a toss. So now I've tossed everything in my midin salad, it's ready to be served. So now that I've plated my midin salad, I'll be adding a few toasted peanuts on top for the crunch. So our deliciously refreshing midin salad is done. We'll look at our next recipe, which is midin goreng chili. So now we will be looking at our next dish, which is midin goreng chili. So here the midin, just now we only use the shoots, but here you can use other parts. What you have to do is you just break it into smaller pieces until the softer stem, and you can use it. We also have here red chilies, bird's eye chilies, dried chilies, turmeric, shallots, and garlic. All of these I have ground into a paste like this. To add a little bit of a savory flavor, we are using krise, which is actually toasted coconut that will release its flavor. So now let's look at how we are going to do midin goreng chili. So I'm pouring a little bit of oil into a pan that is heated. Along into the pan, I'm going to put some of the ground chili paste just now. Along with the ground chili paste, I'll also be adding in the krise. But first we'll give this a stir, and then we'll add in the krise. So now that it has been sauteing for a while, the spice paste along with the krise, I'm going to add in some salt and also a pinch of sugar. Krise is actually toasted coconut which has been ground into a paste. You can find this in supermarkets or even in the wet markets. So once I've added in the salt and sugar, I'll give it a stir. Make sure your pan is on high heat because you don't want the water to be released from the paku. So now I'm going to add in the paku and fry. So now I've already done my midin goreng chili. I'm going to plate it up. So the krise just now is to replace belacan. Since this is a vegetarian version, it gives the savory flavor that comes from belacan. So now that I've plated my paku, I'm adding a little bit of coconut milk. This is to give a very silky smooth finish to my paku. If you like, you can also add extra coconut milk to this dish. So what happens is that it will be having a coconut milk gravy, something like masala mak. So now we have done two dishes with midin, or here I've used paku. We have done midin goreng chili as well as a deliciously refreshing midin salad. These two dishes are very simple to make and it takes no time at all. I do hope you try these two delicious midin recipes, and I'll see you in the next episode with another Sarawakian dish, which is, we'll look at a vegetarian version of ayam pansor.